learned some lessons, and I hope that those lessons will move democracy forward. Let me start by saying that we must try to concentrate on developing democratic institutions rather than developing powerful individuals. Democratic institutions are what are going to sustain democracy over the years. And I will emphasize that we need to concentrate on developing democratic institutions. Mr. President, distinguished colleagues, I look forward to a day in this country when on an election day, the average Nigerian will go, cast his vote, and go back home like any other day, not what we have currently. Troops are mobilized, all security agents are in their battle dresses, and everybody is tense. I hope that the day will come when we will vote normally like any other country, and the votes will count. Mr. President, distinguished colleagues, I look forward to a day in this country when the election petition tribunals set up will have no petitions before them at all. No petitions because everybody will be satisfied that their votes have been, that the votes they cast will also count. Mr. President, I look forward to a day in this country when at the end of every election, people will go and congratulate those who have won and those who have lost to be told by those who have won that they've done well. I look for a day in this country when party will just be an avenue, a platform for Nigerians to go and cast their vote and determine whom their leaders are, not an avenue or a platform to insult people. I look for a day, Mr. President, in this country when campaign will be issue-based, not on personality-based, where campaign will concentrate on issues that will move this country forward. I look for a day when democracy will be the key word for development in this country, Mr. President. Constitutional amendment, Mr. President, is a continuous exercise. It is true that in 1999, the military handed a constitution over to us, and we've continued to amend it. And we should realize that that's a continuous thing because we continue to improve on our democratic systems. Electoral acts will continue to be amended, and amended so that elections will become simple issues in this country that will not generate or degenerate to the level that we sometimes find ourselves. Mr. President, some of us are living, others are going to remain. For those of us who are living, particularly for myself, and I think for the rest of us who are living, we must remain good ambassadors of this hallowed chamber, because this chamber is what has made us, and we must be good ambassadors for this chamber. Mr. President, I want to say that I, as a person, because I've seen it all and because I've been here over a period of time, I will remain a peace ambassador for this country. I will remain a peace ambassador for this hallowed chamber. And as a distinguished senator, let me remind all of us that in or out of this chamber, we are distinguished men and women, and we must keep that in the back of our mind that we should be good ambassadors of this chamber. Before I sit down, Mr. President, let me thank my distinguished colleagues.